Hey guys, it's a Star War here. You know what? For those of you that got yelled at by your mom and she said, "Hey, here's some money. Go see a Star War." You could simply keep that money and turn on Wash Dad and see Big Ape Productions.
What?
Oh God, am I going to get copyright struck in for this? This is fair use, right? Oh my God, this has copyright strike written all over it. Oh my God, PS1 games were not meant to be on any fucking console or a TV that was made in 2023. Oh no. I think this is fair use. Let me know in the comments. While the Congress of the Republic endlessly debates this alarming chain of events, yeah. Evergreen right there, huh? Huh? Am I right? Congress just endlessly debating? There's a joke in there somewhere. Well, keep letting the genocide happen, or do we not? Also, I really hope that none of this is... I feel like our YouTube channel is going to get its first ever copyright strike. Look at this cutscene. Is it not crazy to think that video games look better now, gameplay-wise, than cutscenes looked on the PS1? That is insane. I've never played this game either, so this is no blast from my past. This is the first time for me. Oh my God, look at that dithering. Look at this 90s ass PC ass game for the PlayStation 1. Oh my God. There's a music video? Not gonna do that. That's probably... Oh, this is how you teach people how to play a game. Very pal world of you. not even actually, because there's none of that in pal world. Let's see. All right, show me. Oh yes. Oh God, take me back. By the way, the recent love that the prequels are getting can eat shit. Oh my God, does this look great? Don't let them cloud your judgment. Oh yeah, this is the original voice cast. When the Trade Federation Viceroy arrives, we must convince him to leave. Oh my God, take me back. Will they agree to leave? Isn't it insane just what assholes we are with video games? Like, people look at God of War or Horizon and they're just like, yeah, whatever, it's not 60 frames. It's not 4K, 8K ray tracing. Like, look at what we used to have to play, man. If you showed God of War Ragnarok to a kid in the 90s, he would have fucking lost his mind. His collective mind. Why is this the view? Why did we choose top down? Yeah, die! Wait! No! No, this is not how the movie happened! Oh my God. All right, kidding aside, it appears as if the Trade Federation is preparing to attack Naboo. Yeah, that's Liam Neeson, all right. Oh, you can rewind. That's cool. Can I please see the controls again? Okay, so run, next weapon, force push, activate, jump, attack. There's no, defend yourself? Cool. Love it. No notes, guys. Also, I'm joking. Okay. I understand when this game was made. No! Leave me alone! No! You do not beat me! I swear to Christ, if any of you fucking write skill issue on this as to why I can't beat it, I'm going to find you in your actual homes in real life. I'm going to break into your house, and I'm going to fucking tell you, you know what? You're right. Have a nice day. Can I
be patient, Obi-Wan. The solution to this problem is here somewhere.
Excuse me, is this a puzzle game? Well, the solution to the puzzle was to literally... What? Oh my god. I'm gonna take a look at the old controls again. What? Is there a push button? Oh, the circle button is to activate. Okay. Silly me. Wow, Qui-Gon is upset with me. Oh no! Obi-Wan's dead! What am I supposed to do when they're just shooting at me relentlessly? There's no, like... swap the buttons back at them? By the way, I fully... Wait, okay. The love that these games, or games, I hope not. The prequels all still suck, by the way. You're just remembering a time where you were younger and things were nicer.
Will they agree to leave?
I will give the prequels this. We've gotten a lot of extended universe material from them. You know, we got that entire Clone Wars show on Cartoon Network. We got the Jendi Tartatovsky. Game as well.
The room is filling with poison gas.
Oh, okay.
Must escape.
Oh my god, this is the Dark Souls of shitty PS1 games. Gonna kill a dumpster. All right, wait, what? Oh my god, I keep using the joystick by mistake. Folks, we used to have to use the D-pad on the PlayStation, whether you wanted to or not. Okay. Oh my god, this D-pad feels awful now. The D-pad on these games, on any modern games, is usually like to take out a weapon or some shit. The fact that this was like actually how we moved. Oh, come on! I like how he just like swipes at it like a fucking like, nyeh. Nyeh. Oh, he won't do it now because I activated it.
Door is open. Let's go.
Okay. Let's go. Oh, is it health? Yeah! The game even knew that I would suck for this. Wait. Qui-Gon seems to be, like, defending himself. Oh, if I hold it down, he swings it like a fucking toddler. Look at this. Meh, meh, I win, Daddy. Fuck you. Meh, 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 meh. Man, games were really better back in the day. Like, thank God, you know, because, like, now you upload a game and it needs a day one patch. But back in the day, we got to put our games in our PlayStation with no day one patch, and they looked and played like this. And you were just stuck with this. Yep, truly better times. Modern games can take their day one updates and shove it. I would rather play this, right? Everyone, are we in agreement? Let's go. Do I wonder what the boss fights are like? Do. Hey, by the way, Disney Plus, is it too much to ask for a fucking Star Wars What If show? Like, is it? Wait, what? Qui-Gon. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy, old pal. Hey, buddy. Like, come on, man. It just seems like a no-brainer. Like, it's pretty successful. Like, most people like the What If Marvel stories. I know I do. What do I do? What do I do here? Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Okay. All right. Well, I mean, I can't argue with you. Like, come on, man. Literally, episode one. What if Anakin had never... What if Anakin had never fallen to the dark side? What if Qui-Gon Jinn had never found Anakin? There's like, what if Anakin had listened to Mace Windu? There are like 18 episodes you could do with Anakin Skywalker. Oh! God damn it. Games are beautiful. What if Obi-Wan had won that duel? You know, with Anakin, or wait, well, he did win. What if Anakin had won and not had his legs chopped off? Like, what would Darth Vader have been like without having to wear that massive, stupid suit? You know what I mean? Like, come on. It's just endless. What if, even from the new movies, like, what if Finn had force powers? What if Ben had never killed his dad? Like, come on, man. Get a room full of writers going and just fucking have fun with it. It seems so goddamn obvious. What if the Emperor had been killed? Like, when he was supposed to be killed, and, like, the Empire never happens. What if Luke Skywalker had been turned and to be made evil? I don't think I can go in there, folks. I think I gotta find another. Like, what if when the Emperor says, you know, kill your dad, what if Luke Skywalker simply did? Like, come on, man. I just wrote the first, like, four seasons for you guys. Get on that shit. I would watch. Obviously, it would be cooler if it was, like, a what if live action, but I understand budgets and shit. But man, the things you could do. What if Qui-Gon Jinn had not died? You know that old saying, like, the duel of the fates is really the fate of Anakin, because, you know, Qui-Gon would not have let him turn. Or so, like, that's what everyone thinks. Like, what if Qui-Gon beats Darth Maul? Oh, God, it, like, upsets me that series doesn't exist. It really does. Also, where the fuck am I supposed to go? We have got a sliver of health left. Oh, I'm supposed to go in that door. Oh, now that other door's open. Boy, oh boy, a dev team was probably real proud of themselves for this one. Oh my god, the tank controls. Can I just say, so this game came out in the year 2000. A few years after Mario 64. Okay, and Banjo-Kazooie. And 3D games just could not. Okay, I'm sorry, these are literal tank controls. Okay. Like, oh, it feels so gross. But, like, Super Mario does not get enough credit for like just what exactly it what it did. Like the fact that Mario controlled as well as he did, and the fact that he like leaned into his jumps and shit is just stupid. God damn it, where is it? Oh my god, where is that fucking door? We need to like practice it in our head. So yeah, we're gonna beat this game. This is gonna be a full series. I'm gonna beat this from start to finish. And nothing I said is true. Obi-Wan, are you okay? Are you okay? Are you okay? Are you okay, Obi? I was also today years old when I learned that they named Leia and Han named their kid Ben because of Obi-Wan. Like, how fucking silly is that? Okay. All right, let's try and remember with our smooth ape brain. Oh my god. Yeah! I did it! Oh, I sound like my daughter. Anytime my daughter does anything now on her own, she's like, I did it! And we... Oh no! Oh my god! No! Oh, there's no autosave! Alright. Alright. I've done the gamer meme. I'm sitting up now. I'm sitting up. So this is gonna be a full playthrough. No death, no hit. God, games were so much better back then. Just no autosaves, no checkpoints, no day one updates, though. You know what I mean? No day one updates. And that one thing makes all old games better than new ones. I saw someone say the other day was Super Smash Brothers, I think like 25th anniversary or 20th anniversary, one of those. The original one? Oh, it had to be, maybe it's 30th. And there were a bunch of people in the comments that were just like, man, what happened to video games? And I was just like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, really? Really, dude? Imagine telling your younger self, okay? Your younger self, hey, man, someday you're going to be able to fucking beat the shit out of Sephiroth, okay? Sephiroth. What the fuck? It's just a gyrating picture of Queen Amidala? There we go. You're going to be able to beat the shit out of Sephiroth with Banjo-Kazooie. Your brain would have exploded. I don't give a shit. Okay? Whatever age you were when the original Smash Brothers came out, you could have been 30. Okay? The original Smash Bros. Comes out, and I tell you, hey man, someday we're going to fuck Sephiroth up with fucking Greninja. And then you would be like, what the fuck is a Greninja? And I'll be like, you know, not important. How does anyone play Smash Ultimate and be like, oh, the old Smashes were better? Maybe from a fucking mechanical standpoint. Sure. Sure. Whatever the fuck your argument is. I know. Which one is the one that had tripping? I know that upset a lot of people. Brawl? That was Brawl, right? Nintendo was, like, mad. I'll watch your back while you search for the controls to this door. That, like, people were playing it competitively. Which is odd. Nintendo was like, how dare you? Wow, so force pushing them just kills them. Door is open. Let's go. All right, Qui-Gon. I gotta get that health pack, though, or I'm not gonna live. how do I open where the health pack was? I did it once! I see you in there. How did I open that door? boy. Well, we're gonna die then. We're gonna die. We're absolutely going to die. Whoa, what's over here? The fuck is this? What the hell?
Don't hurt me. I'm only following orders.
Oh my god, there's fucking... there's like skill trees in this? Oh my god, this is better than Starfield. You know what? I'm not going to lie. This is impressive right here. For a PS1 game?
I am altering your orders.
I accept orders only from Newt Gunray and Runa Hako.
Where is the Viceroy?
I believe the Viceroy is in the control center at the end of this hallway.
So wait, I'm going to have to kill this thing anyway.
Excuse me, but I must be going.
Sorry, you wouldn't listen to me, dude. Oh, God. Is there a button to push in here? Boy, oh, boy. No, I'm making fun of this game, but, like... the more I learn about game development, it really just is amazing that any game exists. With that said, woo boy! This one's a good one. Which makes me wonder, you know, why can't we get, like, a modern, you know, Star Wars that looks through all the movies? Like, why is fucking Lego Star Wars the only fucking game that's like, hey, let's just let you play through the movies? I appreciate the Fallen Order games. I like both of them. I'm not a huge fan of the fucking game design. Or the level design for the second one, but... Alright, well, alright. How the fuck did I open this? Bullshit!
The ship's command center is just ahead.
Libba-da-do! Squee-bee-bee-dee-dee! Squee-bee-bee-dee-dee! Alright, so was I, like, supposed to be able to jump over that? Also. Oh. Alright, hold on. Exit. Let's experiment with this. No. Wow. You guys learned that from the Nintendo Switch. You certainly did. No. Look at. Okay, so I'm supposed to come down here. Got it. Got it. Oh. You know, the prequels suck. Three is doable. That's the general consensus, too. Like, some people say three's good. I'm telling you, folks. I rewatched them all a couple years ago, right when my kid was born, actually, because I was Mr. Night Shift. Girlfriend would take care of her in the mornings, and I would kind of go all night. And we'd switch off during the day. Having a baby is like drowning. And to come up for air, you give your partner the baby, and then you don't drown as much, but you still drown. And so you just take turns drowning, but drowning not as bad. Anyways. You know, I was like, okay, I'm very tired. I'm just going to, like, watch movies or some shit. And I watched the prequels in, like, one night. I drank a shit ton of fucking Monster. Oh, God! Don't you dare! Don't you dare!